हरे कृष्णा क्वेश्चन इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द भगवद गीता इटसेल्फ अर्जुन रेफर्स टू कृष्णा एज माधव एज मधुसूदन माधव इंडिकेट द लॉर्ड ऑफ द गॉड्स ऑफ फॉर्च्यून सो डज ही नो द सुप्रीम पोजिशन ऑफ कृष्णा राइट इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द भगवद गीता एंड देन इफ ही डज देन वाई डज ही वेट टिल द रेवल्यूशन ऑफ द विश्वरूप till he accepts Krishna's supreme position. Answer, there are names which are connected with the divine, but which do not necessarily indicate the divine. So, for example, now one of the names of Arjuna is Vishnu, Jishnu. Sorry, yeah, one of Arjuna's name is Jishnu. So now Jishnu is also a name which is used for the Supreme Lord in the Vishnu Sahasranam and other such names like this. Vishnave, Jishnave, Shankine, Chakrine. So Jishnave. So it can have various meanings. One of the meanings is the destroyer. So the Lord is the Supreme Destroyer. So the point is that when Arjuna was referring to Krishna by these names, his references were more from a cultural or conventional perspective. They were not from a philosophical perspective. So just like we understand that the name Krishna means all attractive and it refers to the Supreme Lord. But there can be people, there can be even non-devotees who may have the name Krishna. And if that is possible today, in today's culture, which is not very devotional, which is quite largely non-devotional or anti-devotional, what to speak of in the past when the culture was largely devotional? So people, quite as a matter of standard, would have names which were connected with the gods. So at the start of the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna, when he refers to Krishna by various names which indicate Krishna's divine position, there it is. That it is more of a from a cultural convention point of view that Arjuna is referring to Krishna by all these names. It is not so much that the philosophical import is being stressed by Arjuna. Of course, the acharyas will explain that what the significance of the name Achyuta is here, what the significance of the name Madhava is here, what the significance of the name Janardana is over here. So we have to understand that when Krishna especially when the Bhagavad Gita is being spoken, Krishna orchestrates Arjuna so that Arjuna seems to go into illusion and then Krishna speaks wisdom that brings him out of illusion. So the principle here is a principle of Arjuna being used by the will of the Lord for the instruction of the world for all time to come. So now if you look at the Mahabharata, before the Mahabharata war, there have been many occasions when great sages have come and they have informed the Pandavas that Krishna is Adya Narayana Puman. He is God himself. Narad Muni tells this, Markandeya Rishi tells this, in the forest especially. And there are many occasions when the Pandavas have heard about Krishna's divinity. When the Rajasuya Yagya is performed, the Pandavas give the Agra Puja to Krishna because they understand he is the Supreme Lord. So Arjuna also definitely knows this. But the point is that at this particular time, at the start of the Bhagavad Gita, by Krishna's arrangement, Arjuna comes under illusion through his yogmaya potency, and that's why he starts asking questions which enable Krishna to raise Arjuna, to educate Arjuna, and through Arjuna to educate all of us. Now, so when Arjuna is under illusion by Krishna's arrangement, he focuses. Now he will not suddenly stop referring to Krishna by all the names that he knows, and it's not that when he's under illusion, he has forgotten the names of Krishna. He still remembers the names, but by the Lord's arrangement, the philosophical import of the names and the position of Krishna that is conveyed through his names, he forgets that. So that means just like a friend may have a name Krishna, or even in today's time, sometimes people have five, six names. Of course, nowadays 5, 6 may not be common, but 2, 3 are common. You know, one may be a legal name, and then one may be a nickname, which is there. So, like that, different people have different names. So, now these different names that are there, These are real names. From the point of view of those people are actually referred to by those names. So, but it's not that if somebody has a name Krishna in this world, that person is going to be all attractive. So when Arjuna refers to Krishna by names like Madhava and others, he is referring to them because those are the many names of his friend Krishna. He is not aware of Krishna's supreme position, but he speaks those names because those are the names by which he knows his friend. So that those are more of cultural names rather than names with philosophical import, at least the way Arjuna uses them at that time. But later on, when Krishna becomes illumined by Arjuna's explanations, then he takes those names and uses those names. He understands Krishna's position and then he acknowledges Krishna's position. Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram Paramam Bhavan. And he identifies Krishna's supreme position and surrenders to him. So in the beginning, the names are more of cultural usages, not so much as philosophical position depictors. Although the acharyas, knowing Krishna's plan, knowing that Krishna has arranged for Arjuna to speak these verses and to use certain names in those verses, the acharyas use it in their commentaries to give us to point to the philosophical position of Krishna through the usages of those names also. But that is not Arjuna's intention when he uses those names. Thank you. Hare Krishna.